WGN presents the 80th McDonald's Thanksgiving Parade, hosted by Robin Baumgarten and Paul Conrad. Join Grand Marshal Drew Sidora, Honorary Grand Marshal Ronald McDonald, Million Dollar Quartet, Budweiser Clydesdales, Giant Tweety and Garfield Balloons, Ringling Brothers and Barnum and Bailey, and more. Brought to you by the McDonald's owner-operators of Chicagoland and Northwest Indiana, CNH Industrial, One Main Financial, and TCF Bank. The McDonald's Thanksgiving Parade, Thanksgiving Day at 8 on WGN. Downtown Chicago, WGN presents the 80th Annual McDonald's Thanksgiving Parade.
Ladies and gentlemen, children of all ages, Ringling Brothers and Barnum and Bailey welcomes you to the 80th McDonald's Thanksgiving Parade here in Chicago at the greatest show on earth.
We gotta build this circus, build it fast with a strong foundation so it's built to last. Build this circus, build it together, we'll make a circus today that you'll remember forever.
We've got the muscle, we've got the plan, we've got the workers, we've got the fans.
Ringling Brothers and Barnum & Bailey Circus. They are at the United Center with their Built to Amaze tour through Sunday. Thank you, guys.
Happy Thanksgiving.
Happy
I'm Paul
Thanksgiving.
Conrad.
I'm Robin Baumgarten. We're here again for the fabulous McDonald's Thanksgiving Parade. We're right on State Street. A little chilly, but the wind's not bad.
Yeah, nice and calm. Beautiful morning for us. And we've got a big day ahead of us here.
So here's how it works. For the first hour of the show, from 8 to 9, we have live performances here right in front of Macy's. And we're after 9 o'clock is when the parade starts.
We're going to check in with Anna Bellevall. She's at the south end of the parade route down near Congress. It's coming this direction. Anna, how's it going?
The Regal Clydesdale horses are here. They're inside the trailer now because they're divas. They need to be warm and cozy. Kat, who is the tiniest person to deal with these gigantic, enormous horses, tell us a little bit about how many horses in the parade and so on.
That's right. We'll have 8 horses in the parade. We're standing here in one of our 3 semis that we travel with. These are 2 of our swing horses, the second pair you'll see in the parade today. This is Tim, and over there is Rock, and these 2 are going to be your front horses, King and Sparky. We were up at 2 in the morning getting ready for the parade, and we're very excited to be in it. We're, I believe, number 3 in line, so keep an eye out for us.
With this weather, how early do you take them out? I mean, and how long does it take to get them ready?
We're still sitting here getting ready. We're trying to wait to the last minute so the horses aren't out in the cold, but we're excited to be in the parade and can't wait for everyone to see the Budweiser Clydesdales.
Oh my God, Robin, Paul, Kat and I, yes, you're right. Kat and I have the lovely front of the horse. You should see where my poor camera guy is standing. Mm-hmm.
Right where he belongs.
We're going to send it back to you.
He doesn't look much different there. Happy Thanksgiving to him. Hey, the Emerald City Theater creates experiences that inspire early learners. And today, they're performing a medley from Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer, the musical.
Emerald City Theater's presentation of Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer can be seen through January 5th. Take it away.
Have a holly jolly Christmas, it's the best time of the year. I don't know if there'll be snow, but have a cup of cheer.
Have a holly jolly Christmas.
And when you walk down the street, say hello to friends you know and everyone you meet. Oh, the mistletoe hung where you can see. Somebody waits for you. Kiss her once for me.
Have a holly jolly Christmas.
And in case you didn't hear,
oh by golly, have a holly jolly Christmas this year. Then how the reindeer loved him as they shouted out with glee. Rudolph the red-nosed reindeer, you'll go down in history.
The Emerald City Theater's presentation of Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer, the musical, can be seen through January 5th.
We're going to step aside for a moment, but first, here's what you're going to see throughout this wonderful parade. Stay with us.
Still to come on the 2013 McDonald's Thanksgiving Parade, performances by Million Dollar Quartet, Elf the Musical, the Goodman Theater's Christmas Carol, plus Thanksgiving cooking tips you won't want to miss when McDonald's Thanksgiving Parade continues. Welcome back to the McDonald's Thanksgiving Parade. I'm Paul Conrad with Robin Baumgarten.
Thanks for saying that
for
me.
I'd introduce
That's really
you,
nice yeah. of you. Yeah, we're here on State Street. It's a little chilly, but no real wind, so it's a beautiful day to come out and enjoy. The performance is till 9 o'clock, and then the parade steps off at 9. Right now, our next performance is by the most renowned Japanese drumming group in the Chicago area. McDonald's Owners, Operators of Chicagoland and Northwest Indiana presents Tsukasa Taiko. Take it away.
Thank you.
There you are. Catchy little number there. Tsukasa Taiko offers year-round group music classes, private lessons, and special workshops for traditional Japanese musical instruments.
Well, many of you watching from home will soon be busy preparing your Thanksgiving meal if you're not already. Joining us again this year with great advice is Chef Denise Norton from Flavor Cooking School in Forest Park. So, Chef, I understand this time...
Are they doing a commercial now?
You're going to school us on mashed potatoes, Denise. How are you?
I gotta believe she's fine.
Hi. I think she's fine.
First thing here this morning. Happy Thanksgiving,
hey,
Paul and Robin.
Thanksgiving. Good to see you. As well.
We wanted to talk mashed potatoes today because, after all, they're one of the biggest stars of your meal. And we cook them often at Flavor Cooking School. And one of the questions I frequently get asked is, how do you make mashed potatoes taste creamy? So I have three tips today for the creamiest, tastiest mashed potatoes. First, keep your mashed potatoes large when you cook them. The smaller you cut them, the more water they'll take on, and they will taste diluted. Second, use a ricer or a hand masher. If you use a food processor or a mixer, that will mix them too much and it activates the starch and they taste gluier. So using one of these makes the starch molecules more intact. And lastly, butter. Add some fat. Butter, sour cream, cream cheese. Any of those things, adding fat will add to the overall creaminess and deliciousness of the potatoes. Now, don't skimp on this today. No one likes a butter miser on Thanksgiving. And I guess my fourth tip today is make more than you think you'll need. Paul and Robin?
Always over-prepare,
yes.
Right?
Yes.
Thanks,
Nailed
Denise.
Nailed the plan to fail, sister.
She's going to tell us about her secret stuffing recipe coming up in our next hit with Denise. So.
Good. All right, Annie Oakley's rise from rural ragamuffin to sharp...
What was that?
Yeah, ragamuffin. that's like a four-syllable word.
Yeah, nice.
Ragamuffin. Yeah.
Okay.
It's not even 8 o'clock. Yeah. her rise from ragamuffin to a world-famous sharpshooter is on display now with the Light Opera Works presentation of Annie, Get Your Gun.
Folks are dumb where I come from. They ain't had any learning. Still, they're happy as can be. Doing what comes naturally.
Doing what comes naturally.
Folks like us could never fuss with schools and books and learning. Still, we've gone from A to Z. Doing what comes naturally.
Doing what comes naturally.
You don't have to know how to read or write when you're out with a feller in the pale moonlight. You don't have to look in a book to find what he thinks of the moon and what is on his mind. That comes naturally.
That comes naturally.
My uncle out in Texas can't even write his name. He signs his checks with X's, but they cash them just the same. If you saw my pa and ma, you'd know they had no learning. Still, they raised a family. Doing what comes naturally.
Doing what comes naturally.
Uncle Jed has never read an almanac on drinking. Still, he's always on a spree. Doing what comes naturally.
Doing what comes naturally.
Sister Sal, who's musical, has never had a lesson. Still, she's learned to sing off-key. Doing what comes naturally.
Doing what comes naturally.
You don't have to go to a private school not to pick up a penny near a stubborn mule. You don't have to have a professor's dome not to go for the honey when the bee's at home.
Get Your Gun can be seen at the Kahn Auditorium Theater in Evanston from December 21st through December 31st.
Well, Paul, for many years, McDonald's has helped make this Thanksgiving parade a wonderful event for people, and not just here in Chicago, but across the country. And joining us now is local McDonald's operator, John DeCarrier. John, thanks for being with us this
morning. Good morning, Robin. How you doing?
Little chilly, but not too bad,
it's
right?
Okay. Yeah,
what does this parade mean to you and fellow McDonald's operators?
Well, you know, I'm one of over 100 McDonald's owner-operators that operate here in the Chicagoland and Northwest Indiana area, and we're deeply rooted in the communities in which we operate those restaurants. And being part of this Thanksgiving Day parade for us It's another way to really spread the holiday cheer to those customers that we serve every day. And we are truly proud and honored to be here supporting this great Chicago tradition.
Well, the holidays is really about giving back for a lot of people. And how does McDonald's make that happen?
Well, you know, serving others is at the heart of what we do at McDonald's every single day. And my fellow owner-operators and hundreds of our dedicated crew members really endlessly donate their time at local food banks, schools, and charitable organizations through not only now but throughout the year, working with organizations that focus on community, family, and children, especially our very own Ronald McDonald House Charities.
Well, John DeCarrier, thanks so much for joining us. Have a happy Thanksgiving.
You too, Robin. Look forward to
a great parade. We'll be back with more from the McDonald's Thanksgiving Parade here on State Street right after this.
Welcome back to the McDonald's Thanksgiving Parade.
The Joffrey Ballet's awe-inspiring rendition of the Nutcracker is a Chicago tradition. Today they're here to entertain us with Tchaikovsky's Timeless Story. Wow, the Joffrey Ballet will perform the Nutcracker from December 6th through the 28th. Thank you so much.
All right, let's check in with Anna Belleval. She's down with the balloons at the start of the parade route. Hey, Anna.
They are the highlight of this parade, the balloons. And the heart and soul of these balloons are people like Amy Kalis, who for 6 years has been holding on to the string so the balloon doesn't go away. How are you?
I'm doing good.
Happy Thanksgiving.
Happy Thanksgiving to you, too.
So why do you do this year after year? It's freezing out here.
Oh, it's so much fun. We started having my sister come in from Galesburg, Illinois, and my family comes down. We all do it together. We have a bunch of friends on one balloon, so it's just become a tradition. We do it every year.
That's really neat. You got Sid the Science Guy, Fufa, elevating as we speak. They're being inflated. Yeah. About the hats, lots of people with funky hats.
It becomes a personal challenge, I think. Mm-hmm. You just want to win. We all have been getting matching hats for years, mm-hmm. So our whole team always matches. And I think this year there is actually a hat contest, so someone's going to win the hat contest, I think, from this whole group this year.
I think so. Happy Thanksgiving, Amy.
Thank you very much.
Check out the balloons and take a look at the hats too. Back to you.
The beloved holiday tradition, A Christmas Carol, is full of bah humbugs, but is also filled with lots of magic on stage, as presented today by the Goodman Theater. Thank you. The Goodman Theater's production of A Christmas Carol can be seen through December 28th.
We are grateful to CNH Industrial for supporting the parade this year, and we are joined by Catherine Morgenstern. Thanks for being with us.
Oh, thank you so much for having us.
So tell us a little bit about how CNH Industrial is participating this year.
Well, this year we have all of our brands from North America represented in the parade today. We have two tractors in the parade today as well. We have the Case IH Steiger 620.
Are these those giant tractors?
They are.
The kids love those,
yes.
Right?
We love them too.
Yeah.
So we have the Case IH Steiger 620 Quad. That was the 2014 winner of the Machine of the Year Award. And New Holland has their T8 Genesis tractor, and that's pulling our fall harvest float.
So why does your company get so involved in this parade every year? Why do they enjoy participating?
Oh, our employees over the years have absolutely loved being able to participate in such an iconic event in their community. And for those employees that come from all over the state to pull the giant inflatables and to ride in our fall harvest float, it's so much fun. But for us, it is always such a surreal experience to bring these gigantic tractors, farm equipment into downtown Chicago. We get such a kick out of it. We hope everyone else does too.
Well, Catherine, thank you so much. Happy Thanksgiving.
Happy
Thanksgiving
to you too. Thank you so much.
All right, now ready to perform for us on State Street is Romovitsia, the Ukrainian Dance Ensemble of Chicago. The word Romovitsia translates into English as thunderstorm, and here's why. Yeah. Romovitsia boasts a history made up with unique choreography, varied styles of dance, and diverse talent. We're going to take a break. We'll be right back.
Welcome back to the McDonald's Thanksgiving Parade. You're watching live performances here on State Street in front of Macy's. This year marks the 30th anniversary of the Chicago Gay Men's Chorus. Today they're thrilled to perform a number called Turkey Lurkey Time. Take it away.
Christmas, some mistletoe-y Christmas, a turkey-lurkey Christmas.
Thanks so much. The Chicago Gay Men's Chorus, they're preparing for their annual holiday concert, Making Spirits Bright, showing the first two weekends in December at four venues in the city and the suburbs. Paul?
We're thankful for One Main Financial for supporting our parade this year. We have Dan Olson with us. Dan, how are you? Happy Thanksgiving to
Doing
you.
Terrific.
Good
Thank
to
Paul.
See you. This is your first year in for the parade. What does this mean for you guys?
Well, the Chicago Thanksgiving Day Parade is just a wonderful holiday tradition enjoyed by Chicagoans and people across the entire country. One Main Financial is just proud to be part of this great event.
Yeah, can't blame you there. Hey, tell us a little bit about the product services. If someone walks into one of your branches, what are they going to find?
Well, One Main Financial is you know, committed to the communities where we live, work, and do business. You know, from all the branches across the country to the 15 here throughout the Chicagoland area, we provide personal loan solutions that fit customers' needs and their budgets. You know, I would invite everyone, you know, to visit one of our over 1,100 branches across the country. And you can easily find us by visiting us on the web at onemainfinancial.com.
Great.
And from everyone at One Main Financial, we would like to wish everyone a happy Thanksgiving and a wonderful holiday season.
Thanks so much, Dan. Happy Thanksgiving to you. Good
Thank
to see you,
Paul. You.
All right.
Black Ensemble Theater's production of Reuben B. Eccles' Once Upon a People is an original fairy tale told through spoken word, music, and dance. And it's a touching and warm adventure perfect for the holiday season. Take it away.
To honor the union of our daughter, Princess Erin and Prince Oba, Prince of Sincere, we sing!
Sing, 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 sing!
We dance!
Dance, dance!
We make festival!
Once Upon a People can be seen at the Black Ensemble Theater through December 29th. We'll be back with much more from the McDonald's Thanksgiving Parade.
Welcome back to the McDonald's Thanksgiving Parade. One night at Sun Records in Memphis, an auspicious twist of fate brought Johnny Cash, Jerry Lee Lewis, Carl Perkins, and Elvis Presley together. That is the backdrop for the wildly successful Million Dollar Quartet playing at the Apollo Theater.
Well, it's a one for the money,
two for the show,
three to get ready.
Now, go, cat, go,
but don't you step on my blue suede shoes.
Well, you can do anything, but lay home of my blue suede shoes.
You can knock me down, step in my face, slander my name all over the place.
You can do anything that you want to do, but I'm a honey lay off.
Train is coming, it's rolling around the bend, and I ain't seen the sunshine since I don't know when. I'm stuck in Folsom prison, and time keeps dragging on. But that keeps rolling on down the St. Angel.
You ain't nothing more to hound dog crying all the time. You ain't nothing more to hound dog crying all the time. Well, you ain't never caught a rabbit and you ain't no friend of mine.
Come on over, baby, whole lot of shaking going on. Come on over, baby, baby, you can't go wrong. I ain't begging, whole lot of shaking going on. Shake, baby, shake.
It's in its sixth season at the Apollo Theater.
Time to head back down to the staging area, way down State Street. Check in with Anna. Hey, Anna.
Good morning. The folks from Chrysler have brought a unique float with a wonderful driver, Kuno Whitmer, who drives for the SRT Motorsports. Good morning, Kuno.
Good morning. How are you?
I'm doing great. My God, you must be freezing.
Yeah, I should have worn all three layers that I'm usually used to.
More than one of these you should have worn. What are you driving this morning?
I have the privilege today to drive a 2014 SRT Viper GTS in this beautiful red color. And the folks at Chrysler and SRT gave me the chance to drive it today. Unfortunately, we're not going to take it more than maybe 5 or 10 miles an hour. But
you shouldn't.
No. What I'm usually used to, you know, taking one of these about 190 usually down the racetrack. So, a little bit of a controlled environment.
It is beautiful. I think it should be. It is the sexiest float in the Thanksgiving Day parade.
Oh, definitely is. I mean, we just can't wait to get this thing going here. It's such a wonderful day for everybody.
Crank up the heat and enjoy your day. Thank you, Kuno. Nice to meet you guys. Back to you.
Known for their distinctive high-kicking performance, we're now pleased to present the Kilgore College Rangerettes, the first collegiate dance drill team in the world.
Right, kind of town, Chicago is a boozy rockin' town. Chicago is Santa's favorite town. Chicago is, it's full of Christmas joy. Window shopping on State Street, candy canes on Rush Street, and snowmen on Ohio Street. Can't you see it's Christmas time? The snow is falling to the ground. Can't you hear the Christmas sound? Sleigh bells ringing, are you listening? Come on, come on, it's Christmas. Merry Christmas in Chicago.
They become the model for all drill teams created since. Paul?
Well, we're grateful to Zycam Cold Remedy for supporting our parade this year. Joining us is Lori Norian. Hi, Lori. How are you?
Hi.
Good to see you. So Zycam's a cold remedy. What's the outlook for this cold season?
Yes. Cold season is underway, and it will peak in January or February this year. If you do get a cold, you can actually suffer with it for a full week.
Sure.
That's why there's Zycam. It's a pre-cold medicine. So you take it when you start to feel a cold, that first sniffle, that first sneeze, maybe a little tickle in the back of your throat, and then Zycam will actually help you shorten your cold.
So how's it different from other remedies that might be out there.
Yeah, so Zicam is actually completely different from cold medicines that you would take to treat a cold. So Zicam Rapid Melt's an oral mist. It's clinically proven to shorten a cold when you take it at the first sign. So there's actually something you can do to feel better faster.
Great. Well, listen, we appreciate your support there this year. Good to see you. Happy Thanksgiving to you.
Thank you.
Thanks, Lori.
Let's go to a break. We'll be back with much more from the Thanksgiving parade right after the break.
Welcome back to the McDonald's Thanksgiving Parade.
I'm Robin Baumgarten. That's Paul Conrad. We're here on State Street. The parade is going to be stepping off momentarily. A couple of more great performances to get in. Broadway in Chicago presents Elf the Musical, a modern-day Christmas classic, sure to make everyone embrace their inner elf.
We'll spend mornings holding hands and making plans on whether to play jacks or kick the can. Then for lunch a ginger snap, then a nap to fill the gap between building forts and playing Superman. And if his back gives him a spasm, well, every good dad has him. I'll bring him cocoa and a heating pad. It's a scene inside a snow globe. It's a very apropos globe. Just Buddy and the world's greatest dad. We'll share a whole fruit cake slice by slice, making sure not one single crumb drops. And if I were to say I'm in a Christmas play, he wouldn't miss it for a million gumdrops. When I fall and scrape my knee, he'll kiss that knee for me and make that boo-boo better in a jiff. And if I should get a cold or just allergies from mold, he'll gazoon tight me with his own handkerchief. And if ever things turn gloomful, I'll know that there's a room full of hugs and jokes to make it seem less bad. I can't hide my admiration for that perfect combination of Buddy and the world's greatest dad. So I'm gonna try my best to be everything you'd expect of me. And I promise that I won't stop until I'm done.
That's Elf the Musical. It can be seen at the Cadillac Palace Theater through December 15th.
All right, it's time to check in again with Denise Norton from the Flavor Cooking School in Forest Park. I'm supposed to talk about Stuffin' Muffin, which...
Stuffin' Muffin.
Ah, that was your nickname in college.
In college, yeah. Yes. For my freshman and sophomore year, then things kind of went downhill.
I don't even know what to say to that.
Yeah. Hi, Denise. How are you?
I'm good. Happy Thanksgiving. So we are doing individual Stuffin' Muffins today. This has three great advantages. First, each portion gets a crispy exterior because, let's face it, who doesn't like the crust? Second, they take less time to cook because you can put them in the oven after you take the turkey out. And third, you can vary it up for picky eaters or people who have differences in opinion as to what should be in them. Plus, aren't they so cute, Paul and Robin?
Oh, adorable. Yeah. Heavens to Betsy.
Stuffin' Muffins.
All right.
Denise Norton, thank you so much. Well, each year the Chicago Festival Association produces the McDonald's Thanksgiving Parade, and joining us now is their executive director, Phil Purovich. Thanks for being here again, Phil. Happy Thanksgiving.
Happy Thanksgiving,
Ignore
Robin.
Ignore my hand warmers in the old hand here. So tell us, the 80th year of this parade, what does it mean to the city?
You know, it's a great opportunity for families in Chicago to come out and celebrate Thanksgiving together. We really create lifetime memories for everyone here. And we have people now coming to the parade from all across the country. Chicago is now a destination for Thanksgiving. And they stay at our hotels, they eat at restaurants, they shop at the shops. I mean, it's a great economic generator for the city as well.
So for people that are here watching or watching at home, what can we expect this year? What are they going to see? Big balloons, I assume.
Big balloons, always a big favorite. Pac-Man, Fufa from Yo Gabba Gabba. But, you know, we've been doing something really special at the end of the parade for the last few years, and this year is not going to be an exception. We're going to have a special treat for all the viewers.
All right, we got to stay tuned to the end then.
Absolutely.
Phil, thanks so much, and happy Thanksgiving.
Happy Thanksgiving,
Robin.
Great
to see you again, Paul.
All right, this year marks the 80th anniversary of the parade, and to commemorate the first parade in 1934, Coast to Coast Productions is here to perform a 1930s-era jazz performance, Snow.
Snow, snow,
snow,
snow,
snow,
snow.
won't be long before we'll all be there with snow.
Snow, snow. I want to wash my hands, my face and hair with snow.
Snow. I long to clear a path and lift a spade of snow.
Snow. A great big man entirely made of snow.
Snow, where it's snowing all winter through, that's where I want to be.
Snowball throwing, that's what I'll do. Oh, I'm longing to ski through the snow.
Those glistening houses that seem to be built of snow.
Quilt of snow. I'll soon be there with snow. I'll wash my hair with snow.
And with a spade of snow, I'll build a man that's made of snow. I'd love to stay up with you, but I recommend a little shut eye, go to sleep. And
wow, how cool is that?
That was kind of cool, yeah. Coast to Coast Productions is a special events company that provides high school dance students the opportunity to perform in parades and bowl games. We're going to take a break.
Parade stepping off momentarily. Come back after the break.
Hi, everybody. Welcome to the 80th McDonald's Thanksgiving Day Parade. Beautiful day here.
It's great. It's on State Street. We just got finished with a lot of great live performances right behind us here across from the Macy's. And
it's time for the parade to get moving.
It is finally time for the parade to get moving. And we're going to have it all start with our honorary Grand Marshal, the big man himself.
There he is.
Ronald McDonald on his giant red shoe.
Yeah, it's a 25-foot long shoe, which, you know, I don't know what size that makes it, but it's 10 feet high.
It's a big shoe.
Yeah.
Ronald is here on behalf of the McDonald's Owners Operators of Chicagoland, Northwest Indiana, the sponsor of today's parade. He performs in hundreds of educational programs every year, Ronald, you know. He's been around for a lot of years there, Ronald.
Yeah, looks good.
Looks good.
I'm waiting to see his hair turn gray or fall out.
Nope.
He's going to start looking a little funny when that happens.
Hasn't happened yet. Yeah. That's good genes.
Yeah.
Good genes. He goes around and he talks to kids about being a good friend, anti-bullying, giving back to your community. Does a lot of trips.
Sure,
Ronald.
Yeah. Busy guy.
Good for him. Good for him.
Yeah. That's being received fairly well.
Yeah. Well, you know, it's everyone loves a big inflatable shoe.
Right. And the Grand Marshal.
Uh-huh. It's the big kahuna of the day.
Yeah. Yeah, I hear you.
A lot of people here, Paul, despite the fact, how cold is it? I don't want to step on your toes.
I don't even know. I just know it's cold. I'll look into that and let you know in the next few minutes.
All right, well, let's move on. McDonald's Owners, Operators of Chicagoland and Northwest Indiana present the Rich South High School Marching Band from Richden Park.
75 members under the direction of Stacy Neat. They've performed in several prestigious events, including the 2012 Summer Olympics in London and the 2009 inaugural parade in Washington, D.C.
This year they're going to perform at the Kennedy Space Center in Florida.
Now, if you have a black and white TV set at home, they're wearing red, white, blue, and silver.
Thank you.
I always forget there's a handful of people out there. Who...
Are there still?
No. But it's in the script here, so I feel obligated to come up with some justification for saying.
Second year in the parade. Let's give them a listen, folks.
right, they look great. Hey, just a quick update. It's 25 degrees with a wind chill of 19 here.
Thanks. Glad you had to look that up on the internet, weatherman. All right, here's the Budweiser Clydesdales, the 80th year of the Clydesdales as well. They attend 120 events a year.
That's like one every other day, is that right? In a year.
That's quite a schedule.
Yeah.
Oh, look at the old Dalmatian on deck there. They are huge, too. When you see them in person, you cannot believe how tall those horses are. Yeah.
All right, the Barefoot, One Main Financial presents the Barefoot Hawaiians. This is their 30th year bringing Aloha to the Midwest with a home base in Des Plaines. They're warming everyone's hearts with the sights and sounds of paradise. And I always worry because initially you look at this group and you're like, they're not barefoot. They may be Hawaiian, but I was like, they're not barefoot. But then sooner or later, there's a group of guys that start showing up that are barefoot and Hawaiian.
And I don't know how they do that in this weather, but, you know, you get used to it, you get used to it.
Yep. We're getting closer to the barefoot part, I got to believe.
Yeah. Well, that's an interesting take on the grass skirt. Yeah. Braided.
Yep.
Yeah.
Boy, look how happy everyone looks. There we go. We're getting closer. Bare-chested.
Look, there you go. Bare-chested and barefoot.
Yeah.
Oh. Yeah. Cole just looking at him. Oh, one guy's got shoes on.
Yeah, that's all right.
Well, he doesn't want to lose a toe.
He doesn't look Hawaiian, though, either, but we won't say anything.
Hey,
there we go.
Oh, man.
You want to make sure they hang on to those tight. You'd hate to have those go flying into the stands.
That's trouble.
My forehead.
Especially when you got a big balloon behind you.
Yeah, boy, it'd be exciting, though, but, you know.
Case IH presents Teddy Turkey. The colorful mascot of the parade. He reminds us that sharing with others and being thankful for what we have is what Thanksgiving is all about. You can follow, he has a Twitter handle.
Oh,
you
really?
Can follow Teddy Turkey.
There he is.
On Facebook and Twitter.
Yeah. He always leads from the hips. That's one thing I've noticed. I've been at a few parties with him. He leads from the hips all the time.
Oh, look at that.
There he is, bottom left, yep.
I'm just glad we didn't get those super strong winds today. Like they were getting on the East Coast, so we can have the big balloons.
We're living right here.
Oh, what? Is the old booty spank?
Yeah, the old booty spank. I tell you what, you hang out with that guy for any length of time. He tears it up. The chicks love him. All right, WGN Radio presents the Michigan City Soul Steppers Drill Team. Their vision is to change the negative image of youth by promoting positivity through the art of stepping.
They perform at several local events, plus the New York City Veterans Day Parade, Kentucky Derby Festival, lots more. This is their fifth year in the parade.
Yeah, they're stepping right along there. There they go.
Let's listen to them go. Oh, the big tractors. You know I like these, Paul.
Oh, yeah. I know you do.
It's New Holland Agriculture presents the Genesis T8 tractor and the Fall Harvest Float. This tractor is the longest wheelbase in its class for unmatched stability.
Yeah, the old Genesis T8. Don't have to tell me that.
I know.
It features a precision-designed front end that allows impressive 55-degree turning angle for tight turns.
Tight turns are important.
Yeah.
What do you always say?
If it ain't tight, it ain't right.
True enough.
Or something along those lines. The Battle Creek Central High School Bearcat Marching Band from Battle Creek, Michigan here. 120 members under the direction of Bryce Busick. Their motto is Pride of the State. Their eighth appearance in the parade.
Boy, they sound great.
Yep.
That's the Battle Creek Central High School Bearcat Marching Band. Much more with the 80th annual McDonald's Thanksgiving Parade after the break.
We'll be right back.
Welcome back to the 80th annual McDonald's Thanksgiving Parade. You see a big balloon on its way down State Street. What is that?
Hello.
Well.
Not sure.
Huh. Well, Hostling International presents Renacer Bolivianos dance troupe from Chicago. This is the year of the Morenada. It was born from a symbiosis of dance attitude and by imitation and satire of slaves. Renacer Bolivianos' mission is to promote Bolivian culture in the United States and to assist needy sectors of Bolivia. Oh, they've got to be chilly.
That was an excellent read on your part.
Thank you.
A lot of complicated words.
Annabelle Laval gave me the heads up on the read before the show.
Congratulations to her and you. You pulled that off nicely.
Now, this would be a nice outfit for me.
And me.
Yeah. You're right. You've got good legs. You could pull it off.
I've been trying to wear a corset a little bit more around
They're
the
very
house.
Slimming.
Yeah, they are.
You know, that makes your waist naturally smaller.
When I was up cooking the turkey last night, I had one on. I love when they tell us to get moving.
I know. Our producers in here are going, please stop talking.
Pepsi Beverages Company presents the Red Hat and Purple Chaps. They're the first equestrian chapter of the world-famous Red Hat Society.
The members range in age from as young as 10 through past 79 or ageless. Oh. Ladies wearing those red hats are over age 50, while those in pink hats are under 50. No way.
As seen right here.
They look lovely.
I had my purple chaps on last night with my corset doing the turkey.
Man, you're really a trendsetter.
This might be a good time to give a shout out to all the people who asked that we'd be taken off this parade. Sent the great letters last year.
Hasn't worked yet.
No. Still trying.
Case Construction Equipment presents Garfield and Pookie.
Oh, yeah.
Everyone loves Garfield, one of three world premiere balloons this year's parade.
Had you heard of Pookie before?
I have not. Maybe it's Garfield's little stuffed animal friend there, a little teddy bear. Yeah, it's his best friend.
That's nice.
Created by Jim Davis.
Everyone needs a friend.
This balloon, 50 feet long, 6,000 cubic feet of helium, takes 18 handlers to guide him down State Street.
Wow.
Looking good.
Yeah, he is looking good.
Boy, people love the big balloons, Paul.
That is a universal truth.
Yep.
All right. One Main Financial presents the Hendrickson High School Hawk Band from Pflugerville, Texas.
Ooh, Pflugerville.
They look great. 240 members under the direction of Jennifer Shinsanto. They performed in the 2003 Texas State Competition.
No, I think they were formed in 2003.
You're right, yeah.
And then they qualified for the 4A Texas State Competition. Let's stop talking and let them play. Pflugerville, Texas. First appearance in the parade.
Yeah, great to have them in. Shout out to all our friends in Texas
who are
watching.
That's right. And the old Superstation, Paul. You know, when people get a load of us on the Superstation, we won't be here long, Paul.
You're right. We'll get snatched up.
Of course, it hasn't happened yet.
Any day now.
Any year now, I think. They are a big band. Great feathers.
Yeah, those are called plumes. Plumes, yeah. Boy, those are great plumes when you look more carefully at them.
That's a big band, thanks to the
Hendrickson High School Hawk Band from Pflugerville, Texas.
Oh, this is great, Paul. Museum of Science and Industry Chicago presents 501st and Rebel Legions from a galaxy far, far away. They're the world's largest Star Wars costuming group. Who knew there was loves a costume.
I know you do. Don't even act like you're always there trying to find a lover of some
sort. There's something kind of sexy about that Darth Vader,
yeah,
isn't there?
Yeah, kind of a strong, silent type. She's got something going on there also.
Yeah, Princess Leia. So I guess it's an all-volunteer organization.
Of course.
The purpose of bringing together costume enthusiasts under one collective identity. They just promote interest in Star Wars.
Yep.
That's nice.
They're all coming to my house afterwards for Thanksgiving dinner.
And they raise millions of dollars for charities around the world. That's
look at that. That is nice. The old Von Heidecke Dance Center is also home of the Chicago Festival of Ballet. They are from Naperville and have had more than 30 students go on to professional careers, including Olympic gold medalist Evan Lysacek attended this school. Kenneth Von Heidecke is an internationally renowned choreographer whose works are seen around the world and is the protege of legendary ballerina Maria Tolci, which I'm sure you already knew.
Mm-hmm. Always amazed at how much information you have stored up from year to year.
It is remarkable.
Sparkle wagon is a coming down the street. Come on, Paul, sing with me.
Boy, it's always such a treat to be here in the cold. Your singing warms the hearts of so many people.
It's just a tradition.
Yeah. The old Wells Fargo Stagecoach is a symbol of the American spirit. Stagecoaches travel at an average of 5 miles an hour, stopped every 45 miles for meals.
Wow.
Beans, bacons, bread, coffee.
Wells Fargo wagon is
a good song, too.
Coming now, I don't know how I can ever wait to sing.
Oh, yeah.
It's great stuff.
The Mobile Azalea Trail Maids.
Now, this is a tradition. Every year in the parade,
I love this.
They come out to see us. 50 of the best and brightest high school senior girls who serve as ambassadors for Mobile, Alabama. They've been part of this tradition since 1929 in Mobile. And each of the girls design their own dresses. But they all look similar. But I guess, you know, there's little variations on the ruffles if you look closely. Yep. They've also appeared in the Tournament of Roses Parade, the Cherry Blossom Festival in D.C., and Walt Disney World Easter Parade.
Yep. Big shout out to all the people down in Alabama watching this morning. I've already heard from a friend, Bo Armistead, watching online, in fact. Yeah. Bo, happy Thanksgiving to you and
your
family.
You have a friend.
I have. He's
in Alabama.
My only friend, actually.
Hmm.
And he's
good.
A fictional person.
We'll be back with much more from the Thanksgiving Parade. Stay with us. That's one friend.
Yep. That's all you need. Everybody, welcome back to the McDonald's Thanksgiving Parade. We're on beautiful State Street in downtown Chicago. I'm Paul Conrad. I have my dance partner Robin Baumgarten with us, with me here this morning.
And we're going to throw it to Anna. She's down at the street talking to the folks in the crowd. Hey,
hello,
Anna.
Great hat.
Good. Thank you. A viewer made this for me. Can you believe it? Pretty cool, huh?
Yeah.
Happy Thanksgiving to both of you and to everybody. Olivia, you've been coming here for 5 years. What kind of torture do your parents put you through to sit in this cold? I'm kidding. I know you love it. This is part of your tradition now.
Yes.
Tell me a little bit about what's the best part of this parade, of coming year after year on Thanksgiving Day.
I don't know.
The bands.
Okay. Scarlett, first time here, right?
Second time, actually.
Second time?
Her second parade.
She's adorable. How old is she?
She's almost two. She's 20 months, 21 months.
Perfect. All right. They love it here. No matter how cold, they're all here. Back to you.
Thanks, Anna. McDonald's owners of Chicagoland and Northwest Indiana present McDonald's Community Fire Truck. Riding on the truck are several McDonald's operators, all of whom are helping to sponsor today's parade. Now, wait a minute.
Nice.
That's a sponsor?
Yeah.
In the chicken costume?
Yeah, they love to dress up. It may
There's the burglar.
The burglar.
You know, you don't see these characters too much anymore.
Well,
that's
Mayor McCheese.
That's the Grimace?
The Grimace. Where is Mayor McCheese?
They don't trot them out for the commercials anymore. Like,
no,
you
got to stay present.
Yeah, but I wonder if the kids know who Grimace is. But you know what? You put anyone in a costume, it's good news.
Yeah. It might be a little confusing, though, for some people. All right, One Main Financial presents Peruvian Folk Dance Center Chicago. They're promoting the culture of Peru with this tribute to Machu Picchu and the Inca King and his wife. The dancers are in Peruvian attire and are performing traditional Incan choreography. Oh, great colors.
Oh, my.
Oh.
That was a little scary. These are great costumes. 25 degrees, and this parade route is still loaded with people. It's great.
Oh, here we go. Chrysler Group LLC is proud to be powering the parade for the third year in a row. They are featuring one vehicle from each of the company's six brands. The brand new 2014 Jeep Cherokee, the four-door Fiat 500L, the Illinois-built Dodge Dart, the award-winning Ram 1500, the flagship Chrysler 300, and driving the 2014 SRT Viper GTS in Adrenaline Red.
Adrenaline Red.
Yeah. It's race car driver Kuno Whitmer. French-Canadian.
Huh. Adrenaline Red.
Yeah.
Oh, look at now. What, don't you always have dreams about, you know, waking up on Christmas morning with a big car with a bow on the top in your driveway?
Yeah,
No,
not really. You want me to be very honest with you. I'm going to say no, but if you want me to play along, I'll say yes. You just let me know which one next time.
Thanks a lot. All right, Zicam Cold Remedy presents the Fairfield High School Scarlet Brigade from Fairfield, California.
Wow.
127 members under the direction of Brian K. Swetland. They've been consistent winners of band review competitions for many years. Patterned after Cold Steam Guard, red, white, and black. First time in the parade. Let's give them a listen.
All right.
Coming to my
room.
I do. On Christmas morning.
I have those as well.
I feel like I get to know you a little more every year.
Yep. These guys from California, good for them bringing it out here on a cold morning.
That's right.
Their families should be proud as they watch this morning. Generally.
Yeah, they just want us to be quiet while the band's playing. You know, that's the problem.
You telling me to be quiet?
The Cubby Bear presents Chicago Spirit Brigade. This is a nonprofit cheer, dance, and twirl team. They raise money in Chicago for other kids with life-threatening challenges.
Wow, that's nice.
That's great.
Good spellers there.
Hey, this is Sid the Science Kid, brought to you by New Holland Agriculture.
Wow.
Now, this is a PBS show.
All right.
My kids are past this now, so have you have little ones, though.
Yeah,
have you seen Sid the Science Kid?
I can't say that I have. He's cute enough, I think.
He uses comedy to tackle questions kids have about scientific principles and why things work the way they do.
Well, that sounds like a lot of fun.
See, now, if you just leave the TV on all the time, you wouldn't have to talk to your kids, Paul.
I've got to work on that a little bit. He's looking great, though.
He does. He's only 5 years old. He wants to be a scientist when he grows up. That's the idea behind
Sid. Boy, he's big for fine.
Yeah. Why does that stuff
change? How does that work? He's got 34 handlers.
Wow.
Similar to you. What are you up to? You got 35, 36 now? Yeah, you keep firing them.
TCF Bank presents the Kelly High School Marching Trojans from the Chicago Public School System. 75 members under the direction of Richard Daly. Let's give them a listen.
Oh, let's get singing it, Robin. Take a break, but we got a lot more, trust me, a lot more. Welcome Welcome back to the McDonald's Thanksgiving Parade. I'm Paul Conrad from WGN Morning News.
And I'm Robin Baumgarten from the same 80 years, 80th annual parade here on State Street. 25 degrees, but boy, those Garrett's popcorn makers popping away here. You can smell it. You know when you walk by those stores, you can always smell it. Signature stripes on the can there. On board, the chefs are cooking their secret family recipe for caramel crisp and old-fashioned copper kettles, same way you used to do in shops. And they still do in shops every day. And we got some here.
Yep.
Oh, that's good stuff. Passing out to the crowd. A lot of people here. Not too windy, just cold. So
perfect.
You'd say perfect.
Yeah, I'd say it's perfect. We got
like
the old Kinsale Contracting Group presents Rebecca McCarthy School of Dance from Algonquin. These are award winners, by the way.
Trained in a variety of dance styles, including ballet, jazz, tap, hip-hop, Irish step, and more.
I believe they're doing Irish step right now.
So good.
That or they're just cold.
They performed in Ireland, Alaska, Walt Disney World, throughout Chicagoland. Man, I wish I could dance.
Me too, I wish you could. So much better for all of us. All right, Kinsale Contracting Group presents Thistle and Heather Highland Dancers.
Oh, these are the great kilts. I love these.
Mm-hmm. The stirring sound of the great Highland bagpipe inspires this unit of Scottish Highland dancers. They're wearing the tartan kilts, the Argyle hose, complete the look with the matching black fleece jackets. Oh, yeah.
Is that a traditional part of the costume, the black fleece jacket?
I believe it might be, yeah.
Dates back to earlier times. They participate in Christmas around the world, the Museum of Science and Industry, as well as many other local events.
Boy, that bagpipe, that's quite the instrument there, huh? Listen to that for
Pac-Man, big balloon making its way down State Street. New Holland Construction Equipment presents Pac-Man. Another world premiere balloon this year. Pac-Man's still big, huh? It's kind of retro in the video game world, but I guess making a comeback now.
Might as well. Everyone else is.
He's back on a new action-adventure comedy Disney XD series. Pac-Man and the Ghostly.
Adventure comedy.
No, there's really not. It's called Pac-Man and the Ghostly Adventures. Another show you could watch with your kids.
Yeah. Yep.
And then you'll have something to talk to your kids about.
Still trying. Well, he looks like a lot of fun right there.
Yeah. Kids love cartoons.
Yeah, he looks like he's going to punch you. Hey, the Tiffin Columbian Marching Band from Tiffin, Ohio. 145 members under the direction of Michael Meadows. They're known for their high-energy field shows and crowd-engaging musical selections.
Third time in the parade. Let's give them a listen.
All right. WGN Parade.
I try, but I can't do it. How do you concentrate on two things at once?
Yeah, I'm at Paul Conrad if you want to follow along, but it's not easy to do three things at once.
La Casa de la Cultura Guatemalteca.
Oh, that was a good read there, Robin.
Thank you.
Very good.
One of the goals of this group is to let the world know that Guatemala is the heart and soul of the Mayan world.
Yes, indeed. This is our fourth time in the parade. Going on there.
is. Look at this.
Oh, yeah, the old miniature horses.
Bertrand's.
Look how small those were. Do you see those now, first two?
Boy, they almost look fake, don't they?
They do.
Zycam Cold Remedy presents Bertrand's.
Look how small those are. Holy moly. Now that is a miniature horse hair if I've ever seen one.
Zycam Cold Remedy presents Bertrand's Miniature Horses from Watseka, Illinois. They've been around for hundreds of years. I think we have the same discussion every year, Paul, and you're always surprised. They were used as pets for all the royal families of Europe back
those
in the day.
Those royal families.
Now, here's a good idea. You were thinking of something to get Prince George.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, maybe I put one of these in the mail.
They were imported to the United States in the early 1900s, used in the coal mines until modern machinery took their place. I bet they were happy about that.
Yeah, I bet. Hey, you should also mention these horses really kind of get a little skittish when they come across this emblem on the middle of the street.
Yes, here. And we see it with this next group, the Mid-America Cowgirls Rodeo Drill Team.
Yeah. So this,
you can see the horses want to walk around the logo.
Don't tune away now because this is where it could potentially really get exciting. So the horses just don't like, they see that all that writing on the ground there. Either they're trying to read it or get away from it.
Some don't care. But anyway,
turkey.
The cowgirls are easily recognized in their marching uniforms, team jackets, and beautiful white letter rodeo queen style chaps.
Miss Illinois 2013 is Brittany Smith. There she is.
She's joined in the convertible today by Miss Illinois Outstanding Teen Isabel Hansen and by Miss Illinois Outstanding Preteen Layla Haley.
Isn't that nice?
Now look at how great her hair looks, and it's cold outside.
Yeah.
She's all put together.
Her little tiara on.
Look
what
they all do. But I just can't pull it together when I have to dress warm. I have a hard time with that.
Well,
as you saw in the first hour of the show.
Yes, I did. As we all saw. I was bringing it.
Yeah.
You're trying to powder me up.
Yeah.
Put powder on, man. I'm looking great.
You are. You're bringing the sexy today.
Yes, indeed. Again.
All right. The Sullivan High School Screamin' Eagle Marching Band from Sullivan, Missouri. 80 members under the direction of Chuck Moore.
They performed at the Cotton Bowl, the Cherry Blossom Festival in Washington, D.C., and at the St. Patrick's Day Parade in St. Louis.
So first time in the parade. Let's listen to them. Much more with the 80th annual McDonald's Thanksgiving Parade right after the break. Welcome back to the 80th annual McDonald's Thanksgiving Parade, marching down State Street. It's great to be with you. I'm Robin Baumgartner.
And I'm Paul Conrad from WGN Morning News. We're glad you're tuning in here with us this morning. We also have this lovely lady.
Denise Norton, who is a little chilly out there from Flavor Cooking School. She's going to give us some tips about what are you teaching us this time?
Yeah, what's going on?
We're talking about cranberry relish. Now, Paul and Robin, did you know that over 400 million pounds of cranberries are consumed every year by Americans? And during Thanksgiving week, 20%. So according to that my math here, that's 80 million pounds of cranberries this week alone. So we're cooking up some homemade cranberry relish here.
All right.
And you can probably do this with ingredients that you likely have at home already, maybe with the exception of the cranberries. But all you do is put these together, cook it for about 15 to 20 minutes until the cranberries pop and soften and the flavors blend and the mixture thickens. So my Uncle Ronnie is out there right now, and he insists every year that we have cranberries out of a can. But for me, like the tart, fresh, vibrant flavor of cranberries, it's a great accompaniment to today's meal. So now, Paul or Robin, the question is, canned or fresh?
Canned for me, too. Me and Uncle Ronnie.
Canned? Come on.
Those look nice.
Good stuff.
But nothing like a lot of jiggle in my cranberry. I love to see it kind of jiggle around.
Yes, you do.
And
thanks,
pass it around just like that also. Don't cut it up and try to make it look pretty.
McDonald's owner-operators of Chicagoland and Northwest Indiana present the Ronald McDonald Caremobile, brought to you by Ronald McDonald House Charities of Chicago and Advocate Children's Hospital.
They provide free health care to uninsured and low-income children in its well-equipped exam rooms and laboratory.
Children who might not normally go to a doctor get free physicals, immunizations, screenings, treatment, referrals, as well as health education. Last year, they saw more than 2,000 children for physicals, immunizations, and screenings. How nice.
Nice turnout with them today.
Mm-hmm. next group, Paul Intaglio Dental. Oh, wait, excuse me.
No, you got it right.
It's the Denise Sabala Dance Company, right, brought to you by Intaglio Dental Laboratory Incorporated. It's an 80-member competitive dance team, ages 7 to 18, that trains at Denise Sabala Dance Studios in Lake Zurich.
Wow. You can tell these are the competitive dancers.
It's all about the jazz hands and the smiling.
Yeah, big over smile.
You have to sell it.
Yep. Jazz hands.
Jazz hands, jazz hands.
People think dancing's about the feet, but it's really not. It's about a good smile and jazz hands.
Aw, see, they...
Little footwork's required, but generally it's from the fingers
My
up.
Mom always told me to, you always look happier with a beret on.
Did she really?
You did. She did. I mean, you really do.
This explains.
Everybody, happy Thanksgiving here in Chicago.
This is life in the Tatra Mountains float.
Oh, yeah. This float is an example of the rustic life in the Tatra, located on the border of Poland, featuring evergreens, a wood cabin, and a crosswood.
Wow, it's a real sheep in there.
Hey, get me out of here. The carriage pulling the float represents how tourists are driven around the Tatra Mountain Resort. Look at that happy guy.
What do you know? How great.
Oh, yeah, that's nice.
Up next, the Chinese Gong Fu Institute. One Main Financial presents the Chinese Gong Fu Institute in Central China Friendship Association. Students are performing the colorful dragon dance.
I smelled that smoke, Jerry. I thought my shoe was on fire or something with the heater down there. But
nope, you're all good.
I'm all right.
I like those dragons.
Yeah.
That'd be great.
Here we go. The original.
All right, go ahead.
All right, the original. The original Harlem Globetrotters are celebrating their 87th consecutive year, continuing world famous tradition of ball handling, wizardry, basketball, artistry, and one of a kind family entertainment.
And Anna's down in the street with the Globetrotters. Hey, Anna.
Listen, this could be my most difficult assignment yet because I am never comfortable around athletic balls.
Yes.
I always get hit, and then there's horses behind them getting.
I got a twofer here that you can go down with.
Yeah.
Good work.
Yeah. Good recovery. I so back to you because now the
they're gone?
Oh wait, you want guys, can we love do a little trick? What is it? Can we do a little trick?
Yeah, come on.
Don't spook the horses though. Okay, do it.
Just take your glove off real quick.
Okay,
really quick.
Okay,
right
now.
Put your finger up there.
Here we go.
Great nails, by the way.
Yes.
There it is.
In the hoop, baby.
I conquered my fear of athletic balls.
Atta girl.
Thank you, Harlem Globetrotters. Back to you. The horses are coming. Let's go.
Keep walking. The horses are getting spooked out.
Look at that.
The 22nd straight year, the International Horseman has been in the parade, and they're from right here in Chicago.
Sure. They teach the fundamentals of horsemanship economically disadvantaged cowboys and cowgirls throughout Chicagoland.
Oh, one got away there. I was a little scared. Hold on.
Yep.
I think Anna might have spooked the horses.
Well, it's that turkey in the middle of the road also.
Yeah, that logo is never easy on the horses there.
Nope.
Everything's okay.
Yeah, all right. You needed me to jump off the stage here and go wrestle that thing down. I'm not going to do it.
And it might be this big balloon frightening some people, too. Is this the...
That is a little something for
this
me
This is
also.
The Yo Gabba Gabba balloon. It's Fufa. Now, do
sure
your kids watch
nope
this one?
Well, they may. I'm not sure.
Do you know what your children are doing?
I try to stay out of their business. I like to respect their privacy as much as I can.
Hey, good to know.
Yep.
It's a female flower bubble character, pink and happy. She loves flowers, rainbows, and unicorns, and can play the tambourine just like you.
Now, that is not an easy instrument. Probably one of the harder instruments to learn how to play effectively out there. Look at her. Oh, Fufa, Fufa.
Much like me, she has 32 handlers.
Yep. Her realm is a spring or summer meadow. I don't really know what that means, but it's on the list of things to read here.
All right, another great band, Marist High School Band from the south side of Chicago. 115 Bourbon Street presents this band, 120 members under the direction of Andrew Gray. The only Chicago marching band to participate in the Tournament of Roses Parade. Give them a listen. Marist High School Marching Band. We'll have much more from the McDonald's Thanksgiving Parade right after the break. Wow. Everyone loves the Jesse White tumbling team. Always a hit at the parade. McDonald's owner-operators of Chicagoland and Northwest Indiana present the Jesse White Tumblers. Group created in 1959 by current Illinois Secretary of State Jesse White.
Is there on your left, the bottom left? Whoop. Was. There he is.
Sponsored by McDonald's for more than 20 years now.
This gets exciting.
This is great.
Oh, boy. Now, you and I were trying this earlier. I had you up on my shoulders.
You did, and it was
great.
Wow. And then usually we have Anna. We had Anna practice doing this over the top of us.
Yeah.
Now, if Anna really wanted to do crowd participation, she'd get out there.
Bellevue, what are you doing?
Come
get on out there. Standing around on the
sidelines.
Standing
sideline. Around.
Come on. Just missed it. Timing's everything.
Since its inception, more than 10,000 young men and women have benefited from the Jesse White Tumbling
Program.
Yeah,
they do a nice job.
It's really great.
All right, Zycam Cold Remedy presents Ensemble Español, Spanish Dance Theater. Celebrating 38 years of artistic excellence in the Chicago's world-class Spanish dance company.
Here they are.
Fans and the shawls, awesome. Again, this always brings me back to I wish I could dance, Paul, but...
Yeah. Well, you know what? When God doesn't give you the gift of song or dance, you do the next best thing.
And you talk on TV.
Yep. Dance XL is a creative arts center in Gary that specializes in teaching through the arts. Dancers perform an excerpt of their production of The Spirit of the Boab Tree. Does this guy pronounce that right? Boab Tree? I'm not familiar
with it. I'm not either.
Regardless, it teaches children about the beauty and richness of African-American culture with the message that everyone has the power to make a difference. All right, here we go.
It's the Ray of Hope Riders from Lowell, Indiana. They're a drill team of eight brave women of Mexican descent who ride side saddle while executing precision exercises at a full gallop.
Wow.
Side saddle.
Yeah.
They represent the national sport of Mexico and have competed at the state, regional, and national levels. Riding side saddle with a full skirt on, too.
Yeah.
Come on now.
Boy, it gets exciting. I get nervous as they go over that.
Yeah, you saw the horses walk around the logo again.
Boy, look at what a nice little happy prance they've got going on there. Now, see, if we had more dancing horses, I'd be more of a fan of them. So many of them standing around, you know, just looking at each other out in pastures. But if we could get them doing some dancing,
that's
on board now.
Yes, you are. Another big balloon, Paul.
Yeah,
Curious
not a flattering
George.
Angle here. No, we apologize, George. That's a little bit better. Curious George, I'm sure you could recognize him from the earlier crotch shot, but now that we've got a different angle on him,
that's him.
Originated in a series of children's books by Augusto Ray and Margaret in the early 40s. There he is. I recognize him now. All about angles in this business.
It is. It really is. The low angle's not flattering for anybody.
No, it never is.
You know, even if you're a monkey,
should have known better.
You just want to be loose.
Right. You want the best. You always want people to see the best light. I apologize, George, and to your family as well.
TCF Bank presents the Lake Zurich Ice Go Marching Band, 200 members under the direction of Joshua Thompson, one of just three bands from the U.S. selected to play in this year's Cabalgata de Reyes parade in Madrid, Spain. Let's listen. Third year of the parade for them. Marching band. And the color guard doesn't get enough credit.
No.
Let's watch them. That's not easy to do.
No, you're right. Oh!
What the?
This is the Raging Waves Water Park presents Brock the Croc. That's him.
Get it? Brock the Croc!
And his Turkey Day Precision Peddlers.
Ah.
See? Brock is escorting his team of turkeys.
Now, we need hats like that next year for the parade.
Yes.
Come on.
Yeah, you are right about that. It would enhance our credibility.
It really would.
They peddled their way up the State Street here.
How many years do we have to do this parade?
CNH Industrial Outback Road Rally. Look at that. Boy, that looks like a lot of fun, too, doesn't it?
Turkey hats. Turkey hats. That's good stuff.
Anna, how you doing down there?
I'm doing great.
Where are you?
Grand Marshal Drew Sidora is making her way here, and she's a local.
Oh.
Let me talk to her for a second. Hi, Drew.
Thanksgiving.
Thank you. I'm hoping I don't get run over by the car.
No.
The horses are already scaring me.
Yeah.
How are you?
I'm awesome. This is amazing. I've watched this since I was a little girl, being from Chicago. So to be here, it has been absolutely incredible.
Are you still living in the area?
I'm always here.
Always here? I know, because your family's here, and they're very supportive.
Mom is here. My sisters, my manager, family,
crew.
Business, the whole crew.
I love it. Thank you for being a part of this
guys,
year.
It was an honor. Happy Thanksgiving. God bless.
Thanks to Drew Sidora. She's from VH1's Crazy Sexy Cool. That is the movie about TLC.
Who is?
Don't go chasing waterfalls. Just to do
the. All right. Listen, we got a band coming up. We got to get right to that as fast as we can. One Main Financial presents the Bishop Knoll Institute Marching Band. Well, sorry to cut you off there, but we've got a parade going on. Trying to keep our viewers involved also. And people are going to be doing some eating later on, so generally just be careful. All the members of the band are members of the prestigious Tri-M Music Society, which is the musical equivalent of the National Honor Society. You know that?
I did not.
I do. Bishop Knoll Institute Marching Band.
McDonald's Thanksgiving Parade right after the break. Stay with us, folks. Welcome back to the McDonald's Thanksgiving Parade. I'm Robin Baumgarten.
And I'm Paul Conrad. We're glad you're tuning in with us.
We start back with the Assyrian American Civic Club of Chicago. The float represents the Gate of Ishtar, the eighth gate to the inner city of Babylon. I don't have to tell you that. You knew that already.
Yeah.
The gate was considered one of the seven wonders of the ancient world. The goal of this club is to create and promote and spread Assyrian culture, literature, and heritage.
I think I saw the guy from Duck Dynasty in the front there.
Really?
Yeah, there he is on the right.
Ah!
I see he's making an appearance. Didn't know he was Assyrian, but good for him. This is nice. The Florentine presents the Crystal Lake Strikers drum line. With their retro bowling shirts and zebra print drums, this drum corps performs at major sporting events, parades, festivals around the country. They're going to be playing some modern hip-hop. and other catchy beats.
Wow, you got to stay current.
Yeah. Now, they also did the traditional straight-ahead technical material.
Their hands have got to be freezing.
Yeah, well, when you're a drummer.
Now, right behind the Strikers, we have the Tasmanian Devil. We should alert the kids. Don't be, he doesn't look more terrifying than usual on purpose. There's a small terror in his mouth. We had a little bit of a incident with the Taz Devil there. But Case Construction Equipment presents
this
Devil.
He still looks fine. You wouldn't know otherwise.
He still looks good. You know, you do the best you can.
Yeah. It's the holidays. Listen, we're all playing a little hurt.
Did you know that he is the youngest of the Looney Tunes characters,
no,
Paul?
No, really?
Bet you didn't know.
I did not know that. He's the youngest, huh?
Yep. He looks good.
Yep.
Well, he's got some trouble with his arms.
His
you know
older
what?
Siblings are going to be giving him some grief.
The Punjabi Cultural Society of Chicago. They're depicting a Punjabi Indian wedding scene with a bride and groom in traditional colorful attire.
I love these guys.
Their fifth year in the parade, thanks to them for coming out again.
The Old American Side Saddle Association. Side saddle is the age-old art of riding a horse using a type of saddle which allows the rider to sit with both legs on the same side of the horse. Did you know that, Robin?
Yeah, I think I could have figured that out when you said side saddle.
Yeah. But, you know, there's some kids maybe who've never heard of this thing before.
Right.
So that was just for you, kids. You're welcome. Riding side saddle dates back to antiquity and developed in European countries in the Middle Ages as a way for women in skirts to ride a horse in modest fashion.
Yes.
While also wearing fine clothing. I bet you kids didn't know that.
Hmm. And when was the age of antiquity, Paul?
I think it was, let's see, I'm 48. My mom came over on the Mayflower, so I'm going to say like at least 80 years ago.
Okay, good call. Northwest Indiana McDonald's operators present Pantry on the Go. Northwest Indiana McDonald's owners, operators, and the Food Bank of Northwest Indiana have partnered to fight hunger in Lake and Porter counties in Indiana. They sponsor this Pantry on the Go to increase access to foods for those in need of assistance. That's nice.
Yep. All right. LoopChicago.com presents Taiwan Touch Your Heart. Their mission is to introduce Taiwanese culture with live dances.
Oh, look at this.
Yeah.
What?
Yeah.
Well, what is that?
That's, you know, that's one of those things. Oh, that one got loose. Look out.
The dancers are dressed in traditional Taiwanese aboriginal costumes, and the giant techno puppets move along to pop music.
Hey, look at there.
Oh, boy.
Catchy number, too.
Yeah.
I like this.
What are those little yo-yo things? Those are pretty cool.
Yeah.
Who am I kidding? I can't walk and chew gum at the same time. Like, I'd be able to do that.
The Republic County Marching Buffs from Belleville, Kansas. The school has 140 students. 75 of them are in the band. That's nice. And under the direction of Kaylin
Bevermeyer.
Look at that.
It's her first year in the parade. Let's listen.
Thanksgiving parade in beautiful downtown Chicago on State Street. I'm Paul Conrad.
I'm Robin Baumgarten. And now we are joined by the Mid-USA Falun Dafa Association. This float represents the universal principles of truthfulness, compassion, and tolerance. They've been in this parade every year since 2004. You have to just find your inner peace.
I almost found it. Oh, that's nice. Pretty. It's not a day that you really want to be fanning yourself.
No, it sure isn't. They're professionals, Paul.
Yeah, that's nice of them. McDonald's owners, operators of Chicagoland and Northwest Indiana present the dance department of the Curie Metropolitan High School for the Performing and Technical Arts.
They perform around the world, winning an award in Barcelona, Spain. There are 40 dancers in today's parade, ranging in age from 16 to 18. Third year in the parade. But it's really Christmassy, the little Santa skirt there.
Yep.
Do you think I could make that work with the white go-go boots? You think I could do
that? Yeah. Try it.
I know you could.
I know, yeah. Yep. Oh, it's a donkey. Sorry. Excuse me. You know, they all look the same to me.
It's really not nice of you. Donkeys have their own identity,
Paul.
This
is the Mid-States Mule and Donkey Society. They're a multi-state organization that promotes, protects, and offers education to the well-being of mules and donkeys.
Mules. Did you say the education of mules and donkeys?
Yep.
Oh, look, there's Eeyore.
Is he a
probably
donkey?
Their mascot. Yeah, sure.
Huh, I didn't know that. That's a great association.
Oh. How long you been saving that joke?
They wrote that one down for me.
That was great. Oh,
that was funny.
My.
Good Lord. I feel like I've peaked that maybe I should just go sit down somewhere for a little while.
That joke might just get you on international programming, Paul.
I'm sure Matt Lauer probably worried right now.
He's very worried.
As he should be. Yeah. Uh-oh, where are these guys going? What's going on here?
Wait. What?
There's something's not right here.
Zycam Cold Remedy presents St. Paul Winter Carnival Vulcan Crew and Royal Family.
All right. Well, we had an incident going on here.
I thought so, too. The Winter Carnival started in St. Paul, Minnesota in 1886.
Huh. Their theme is fire and brimstone, and the goal is to chase King Boreas, responsible for winter, out of town and allow the return of warmer weather to St. Paul.
Hmm. What do you know?
Don't think that's going to work so well. There's the queen of something.
Information
of the
sorry,
our monitor's too small. That's all right. The Biggest Loser Resort Chicago presents the Rickover Marching Sea Dragons from right here in Chicago.
Sea Dragons,
you don't think of sea dragons marching,
but it's a great nickname. 125 members under the direction of William Henry. It's their first year in the parade.
Oh, good.
They're taking a break, but as they will come, we'll take a listen to them in a second. It's the only band on the planet to use a digital parade banner.
Hope I didn't miss it.
Oh, gosh. Did we miss it? Oh, yeah. No, it's right there. I think we might have. Yeah, right in the beginning. But that's
year.
You have to distinguish yourself. Coming up next, Miss Chicago, it's Savannah Tea Garden. She's joined in the convertible today.
Miss Windy City, Ariel Fuller. Miss Chicago Teen, Grace Etzcorn.
Miss Windy City Teen, Kirsten Thompson. Miss Chicago Princess, Zoe Genghis. And by Miss Windy City Princess, Kamaria Obasi. Did you ever get a chance to wear a tiara? It does feel great.
I know. You feel like you're the queen or something.
Yeah, it really,
very important.
You feel very important. It's great.
Halloween, I like to kind of mix it up sometimes.
You know, you shouldn't just save it for Halloween. You could really, with the right attitude, you can carry it off all year round. You really can.
They're telling you to rap again. Look at this thing here. This is Madeline.
Madeline. Have you read those books to your kids?
No, no, no. And I won't.
New Holland Agriculture presents Madeline. She gave girls the courage to speak their minds. She shows them that there's nothing unfeminine about being smart and strong.
Sure.
You've never read the Madeline books?
No.
Started in 1939, not ringing a bell?
No, I'll get right on it, though, I'm sure. I'll wait for the movie to come out. Then I might. Looks like she's got a bum right leg, but...
She's still making it work, muscling through.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right, One Main Financial presents Pro Dance Elite from Algonquin. Wow, they're bringing it. Got a little noise.
That's right.
Wow. I've got some male dancers in there also. Nice to see. Not the male dancers that you're used to.
Hey, you know, when you've got the music in you.
Yeah.
Look at how cute their Christmas trees.
That's an outfit.
That's awesome. We've got a band here from Van Horn, Iowa. It's the Benton Community High School Marching Bobcats.
All right.
90 members. It's their second year in the parade. That band has almost tripled in size since 2007. Let's
listen. Good
for them.
I got family out there.
You do.
I think.
Stay with us for the Thanksgiving parade after this. Welcome back to the 80th Annual McDonald's Thanksgiving Parade.
The Filipino-American community in Greater Chicago has a simple message. We give thanks to the many people and nations all over the world who have given help and support to the Philippines as a result of one of the biggest and strongest storms to hit land. They give special thanks to all of the people in the Greater Chicago area who generously donated and to all who volunteered their help.
Still recovering there. Unbelievable. In our thoughts this holiday season for sure. And that is the Filipino-American community in Greater Chicago. TCF Bank presents Holiday Horses from Herder Farms in Frankfort, Illinois.
It's a mixture of world and national champion horses, riders, as well as cowboy musicians.
What? Kind of like, what's the famous cowboy singer guy?
John Wayne.
No.
Gene Autry is what they're saying in my ear.
That must have been it. That's what I was thinking of.
The horse-drawn
wagon. He's looking right at you.
Oh, give me the old stink eye. He's walking around the logo again.
They don't like that painted logo on the street. Look at that.
It's making for a really exciting parade, though. That one didn't care.
No, nope, some don't care.
Oh, that is that brass band. Boy, that sounded nice.
Repeat the sounding joy.
No, they are using Appaloosa and quarter horses.
Oh, look at this. Dancing Christmas lights.
Yep, the Chicago Zoological Society presents Brookfield Zoo Holiday Magic, a warm family tradition in the Chicago area's largest lights festival.
At Brookfield Zoo, you can see more than a million twinkling lights. Of course, amazing animals, laser light show.
Boy, those look like they're fun to wear, don't they?
How are they seen when they walk?
Nah.
Oh, it's a polar bear. Look out, Paul.
Thanks for
Dysteria?
Jumping in front of me. Yeah, you had me worried for a second. Those things are vicious. Rip you to shreds. Give me the chance. They look friendly and happy, but
that
you turn your back
asleep.
On them.
Asleep.
Yeah.
Oh, I didn't know they could do the point and wave and the raise the roof. You know, they're really training the animals well.
Magic, All right, One Main Financial presents the pride of Alexander City from Benjamin Russell High School in Alabama. Alexander City, another Alabama group of people. I think I know someone down there.
Great. 160 members under the direction of Dale Bloodworth. First time in the parade.
Oh, great.
Great plumage. And they're getting ready to play here momentarily. I just know it.
Yeah.
Here we go.
Sounding great this morning. Great to have them here with us.
And maybe you saw right behind the band another big balloon making its way down State Street. Mm-hmm. New Holland Construction Equipment presents Tweety.
You want to read this?
Yeah. No, this is when you get to do your Tweety Bird impersonation,
I taught a putty tat.
No. Putty tat.
I taught a putty tat.
Yeah.
I did.
You know,
taw a putty tat.
If you ever want to get on a national show,
all right, let me try
you
it one more
work
time.
On this
I
stuff.
Taught. I taw a putty tat.
Yes.
I did taw a putty tat. I'm available. Let's call 773-883-3100. Ask for Paul. Not there right now, but leave your number.
I have a feeling those calls are going to be flooding in. Flooding in.
Boy, he looks good.
Hasn't aged a bit.
Uh-oh, what's going on here?
This is great here. This is the Chicago Human Rhythm Project, Paul. McDonald's owners, operators of Chicagoland and Northwest Indiana.
Boy, look at all they got going on there.
Present this group.
Are they tap dancing?
They're tapping.
Little step ball change, shuffle step hop.
Huh, you know your moves.
Oh, man, I'm a tapper from back in the day, yeah.
Look at this.
Mm-hmm. The old shuffle off to Buffalo is one of my specialties.
Really?
Yeah.
There's a lot of things I don't know about you.
Yep. Oh, now this is something.
Have you tried this
here.
Kind of dancing?
Not this morning.
The Ramavichia Ukrainian Dance Ensemble of Chicago, presented by LAZ Parking.
They put on a great performance
at the beginning
pre-show.
Of the parade.
Yeah,
oh, gosh. Some of those dance moves that...
Yeah.
I mean, where you go down on one hand, you kick both legs up in the air. I mean,
Mm-hmm, I know.
You know?
Yeah. Yeah. I got shoved out of bed once and landed and got both feet up in the air. It was on one elbow.
You had to recover?
It was just for, you know, a minute or two.
But you know their pain.
I understand what it means to be upside down. And...
I'm sure it's the same kind of training. It's the same thing.
Yeah. They've got a little bit more costuming on than I did, but, you know, whatever. Just a little. The Thornwood High School Marching Thunderbirds from South Holland.
84 members, sixth time in the parade. Let's listen. We're going to go to break listening to the Thornwood High School Marching Thunderbirds. Much more coming up.
Welcome back to the 80th Annual McDonald's Thanksgiving Parade. Beautiful downtown Chicago. I'm Paul Conrad.
And I'm Robin Baumgarten. It's been a great day, a little chilly, but overall, Pretty
yeah,
nice.
Nothing wrong with today.
It's been great.
Sunshine's
been
breaking through a little bit.
And we're going to check back in with Denise Norton from Flavor Cooking School with some more cooking
tips. Yeah,
she's giving
some great advice. Hey, Denise.
Hey, happy Thanksgiving. We're doing quick 1-2-3 biscuits. Homemade
all
biscuits
right.
are easier than you think. Step one is to wazz it up in the food processor.
To
so
what?
Here we've got wazzing.
Wazz. All right.
This is our dry ingredients and some butter.
Okay.
You'd add the buttermilk and wazz that up too to create a dough.
Uh-huh.
And then step two is to transfer the dough to your work surface, pat it out by hand, and cut
all right.
to make your biscuits.
Oh.
And then step three is to bake them till they're beautiful, golden, and puffy, just like that.
Wow.
And then so the recipes are on our website, www.flavorcookingschool.com. And I guess step four is to enjoy them with a nice little slab of butter.
Oh, just
yeah.
a little slab.
Just a little slab.
Paul,
yeah.
you've been trying to wazz it up for years. It
I
hasn't
have,
really worked
yeah,
for
no,
you.
No, I have to be careful.
About the wazzing.
Yeah.
yeah.
Too much butter. You get over wazz and you got all kinds
of troubles.
I knew
yeah.
I shouldn't use that word.
Thank
yeah.
you, Denise.
All right,
Thank
thanks,
you.
Denise. Be good.
What do we have coming down the street
Not
now,
really
Paul?
Not really sure.
Can you see?
Our next group is from Chicago. They are promoting tourism in Durango, Mexico. Durango is one of the biggest states in Mexico, and due to its geography, it's been a great location for Western filmmaking.
Huh.
They better look out. Potato Head's right behind them. They just sneak up and take them out. Boy, that's a nice outfit.
Great outfits. Oh,
I think he's having to
do
that.
Are they supposed to
yeah,
do that?
I think that's part of their show. Maybe.
In my experience with horse
yeah,
riding.
Yeah, yours is horse wrangling.
Well, two-step there.
Well, those are long hair on those horses.
That's really a great observation.
Yeah. You know, they pay me a lot of money
yes,
to make
people
observations
going,
that the people at home may be missed.
Who is this idiot that gets to,
yep.
to MC this parade? Are you kidding me?
Yeah, leave an open chair. I'll sit there for you. Boy, that horse is really dancing over there. You
yeah,
see
look at that.
Uh-oh, what's going on
Up
here?
Up next, we have Zykamp Cold Remedy presents the Szumany Polish Highlander Ensemble from Oak Lawn.
Szumany, yeah.
They're made up of Polish Highlanders born either in Poland or near the Tatra Mountains on the southern part of the country, or born and raised in Chicago. They perform all over the U.S. Their mission is to spread the beauty and pride of Polish Highlander folklore.
Yeah, I love the Polish. My wife's Polish.
Great vests.
Yep.
Oh, another bad angle.
Another bad angle on poor Mr. Potato Head. Sorry, pal. There we go. That's better. Sorry.
Yep. FPT Industrial presents Mr. Potato Head.
Seemingly everyone played with Mr. Potato Head as a kid.
Created in 1949.
He looks pretty good. His mustache still brown or black there?
I think he's in like that Toy Hall of Fame. You know,
really?
he's a bigwig. Yeah. Been around forever.
Did you play with him as a kid?
Yeah, no, I don't think
yeah,
so.
I don't think I did either, so maybe almost everyone.
Almost everyone, but you know who he is.
Sure, yeah.
Famous. In case you know him from Toy Story. Right?
All right, I'm out. The betting experts present the Legacy Dance Ensemble from Midlothian. Look, she's selling it. She just sold it with her eyeballs alone.
Oh. It's all about performing.
Ooh, that's scary. They have the 2012 Grand National Dance Champions. Oh, yeah, that's the nice. Ah, that's nice to see.
Nice. So, wait, we know these people,
yeah,
Anna.
WGN.
There's Anna. Hey.
Hey, good morning. I'm with the family.
Happy Thanksgiving.
From Weather, Demetrius!
It's a fantastic day. It's a little chilly, but we're keeping warm with all the smiles.
Uh-huh.
And everybody having a good time on Thanksgiving.
I know. It's great to see you guys. It's been a fantastic morning. How does it feel, first parade?
It feels pretty good. What's my name again? Do you remember?
Demetrius.
Oh, thank you.
You mean it.
Alice.
All right. Back to you, Mary and Bill.
Thanks, Anna.
Nice to see Bozo.
Bozo.
He's leaned out all
the time. He sure has.
Off.
He's been on a great strict diet. Yeah. He's really slimmed down.
Not working as much helps. Please welcome the, why don't you take this?
You think he's still angry with us for, you know, he's not on every day? Well, we'll talk about it.
He's in his car every time you go by. It doesn't help.
Well, please welcome the Tinka San Simon Dance Troupe from Arlington, Virginia. They're a Bolivian folk dance troupe. And they represent a school of rhythm whose mission is to educate its teenagers the rich Bolivian culture and to keep the kids active and focused on positive hobbies.
Yep.
Dun, 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 dun. Oh, these are great costumes.
Yeah. Oh, hey, look at that hat. That's nice.
Next up, marching band from Kansas City, Missouri. Bill Dorr and company present the Oak Park High School Marching Northwick. Four members in this band, first time in the parade. Let's listen.
Parade to come, including, I believe, Santa's on his way.
Oh, stay tuned, folks. Welcome back. We're in the final half hour of the McDonald's Thanksgiving Parade here on State Street in beautiful downtown Chicago. I'm Robin Baumgarten.
And I'm Paul Conrad. This is the 80th parade here.
80th time. How many years? You're looking
done
good.
Done seven.
They didn't want us before that.
Yeah.
And we'll see how it goes for next year.
Yeah. Hope you're having a great day. Happy Thanksgiving to you.
Happy Thanksgiving, everybody. It's been a beautiful day. And we have Santa's coming soon.
Yeah.
So stay tuned for that. But for now, it's the big tractors.
Oh, yes. This is the Case IH Agriculture presenting the Steiger Quad Track 620 tractor. Look at that bad boy.
It was named Machine of the Year at the Agritechnica.
You don't have to tell me that.
One of the largest agriculture shows in the world.
Nearly
600 horsepower,
yeah,
baby.
Yeah, 25 feet. It's
Look
got also the luxury inside of a luxury automobile.
Inside
those
there?
Guys putting 16, 18-hour days in there. Probably has got a radio and fancy seats.
Wow.
Air conditioner.
Look at that.
Very nice.
Looking good.
He looks comfortable.
All right, we have some horses getting ready to go over the logo here on the street.
Let's
see how this goes. Walking around the side. This is the Culver Lancer Platoon Mounted Color Guard.
All right.
The Culver Black Horse Troop has been in existence since 1897, and last January they were part of the presidential inauguration parade in D.C. Culver Academies in Indiana has two schools, the Culver Military Academy for Boys and the Culver Girls Academy, a private college preparatory boarding school with students from 36 states and 28 countries.
Looking good. When was the last time you rode a horse?
I don't think I ever have.
Huh. You want to?
Yeah, I'm afraid I'll get thrown off. You know, I don't know. I'm a little skittish. Yeah, we'll talk later.
All right. Chicago Park District presents Holiday Happenings. One of the oldest and largest park districts in the country, the Chicago Park District manages more than 8,100 acres of parkland, including 26 miles of Chicago's lakefront.
Riding on the float is the Davis Square Marching Band under the direction of Vernon Lloyd.
Here we go. This is where you make your comment about these. You look good in those sweaters.
Yes. No, I don't look
good in those
sweaters.
You don't look good in the sweaters. One Main Financial presents McNulty Irish Dancers. I better take your Christmas gift back then. They were founded in 1971 in Naperville and now offer classes in Irish dance at 18 locations.
I wish I looked good in these sweaters because they're so cuddly, but it's just, it's too bulky around my hips.
Yeah, I've had the same problem.
You know, you have to roll it and tuck it under.
Yeah, then you don't want to look chunky there.
No, no. It's just
going over the edges. Yep, I hear you.
You know.
You got to have the right physique or be under 12.
Yeah, it's exactly right.
Otherwise, they just don't. But these girls all look nice and cute and happy.
They're all pulling them off great.
Irish dancers, McNulty.
Zicam Cold Remedy presents the Danville High School Band from Danville, Ohio. 55 members, first year in the parade. Let's listen.
Ah, crud, just missed the song. Yeah, it was the second verse, thankfully. Fanfare that we had there. Sorry.
Aren't you getting in the spirit,
yeah,
Paul?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Oh, the sun's out.
Sun's coming out. We've got the Orpheus Hellenic Folklore Society here.
Maybe it's a sign that the good Lord loves me to sing.
Yeah, maybe not. It might just be that the clouds cleared out. So these guys, their mission is to continue the rich history and traditions of the Greek folk culture, dances, songs, music. You know, they participated in the Pan-Macedonian Convention in Greece, and they also at the theater at the foot of the Acropolis.
You're kidding.
Yeah.
I didn't know there was a theater at the foot of the Acropolis.
Yeah, yeah, it's a good one.
It seems like
they show a lot of movies there.
But you'd want to go.
Yep.
How fun would that be?
Yep. This guy here, he did look suspicious.
You love Arthur. Your kids love Arthur.
Nope.
You never watched Arthur?
I'm not a fan of this guy.
New Holland Agriculture presents Arthur. It's all about, he reminds us all what it's like to be 8 years old in the third grade.
Yeah, but he's been on TV like 70 years now already. He's cute, good for him.
And he still beats us in the ratings,
yeah,
doesn't he?
Funded on PBS. I've been spreading rumors about him for years.
You leave
him
alone.
The drug bust.
He's fine. You don't just keep your mouth shut. He's got 34 handlers.
Just kidding, Arthur.
You look great,
yeah,
Arthur.
Yeah, you're a great guy. Good for you.
Doesn't like you, I
keep
do.
Keep moving.
Midwest Appliance Parts presents the Yankton High School Marching Corps from Yankton, South Dakota.
All right.
Huh. First time in
looking
the parade.
Good.
They're looking good. Those are some great uniforms.
Yeah, yeah, sure.
Yankton High School.
Oh, yeah, nicely done. Straight lines here. Good footwork.
You're a marching band guy,
yeah,
from way back.
Yeah.
All right, Santa Claus just minutes away. So don't go anywhere. We're back right after this break.
Don't give up on us now. The worst part's almost over.
Welcome back. We're in the home stretch here of the 80th annual McDonald's Thanksgiving Parade. It's been a great day. And now you're looking at the Cirque Experience Wheel Jam.
Yeah. Whoa!
Holy Moses.
Looks dangerous. We've got to believe it's probably not that dangerous. But
look at the,
yep,
the old wheel jam.
Mm-hmm.
You ever tried that?
Not in the
Your
last
college days,
few
maybe?
Days. No, no.
You really have to have a partner.
Well, So that's much of life gets that way, you know. That's where it gets complicated for some of us.
Yeah, you can't fly solo on the wheel
sometimes
jam.
Sometimes you can bait people.
Yep.
But, you know, it gets embarrassing and expensive.
Mm-hmm. Trained with the world's premier wheel acrobat and world champion gymnast, Wolfgang Bienzel.
Bienzel, yeah.
In his Cirque's Experience team.
Oh, look at her.
Yeah.
This is my favorite here.
Oh, the
Chris Kindle
market.
Market
is great.
Chris Kindle is wearing her golden robe and crown and is surrounded by the children's choir. The Chris Kindle Market in Chicago is an annual outdoor holiday market featuring vendors from around the world who display handcrafted ornaments, toys, and holiday gifts. Opens at Daly Plaza. It's open through December 24th.
Yeah, it's an awesome place to go. Down in the city.
Yeah.
A must stop.
A lot of great Germans, Austrians.
Oh, the old. Oh, well, look at.
That's a, it's got an animal coming out.
It's a mini Ghostbuster. Hollywood Cinemas, Hollywood Palm Cinema Bar, and Eatery present Midwestern Ghostbuster Coalition. Draws a crowd whenever they make an appearance in their authentic costumes.
Yep.
And for every appearance they make, raises funds for cancer research through Race for the Cure. Huh. How old is that movie now? I know you're a big fan.
Yeah, gotta believe. 1984, if my recollection is correct, and the guy in my ear, 1984, that's like 30 years, is that right?
Yeah, yeah.
Good for them. Case IH Agriculture presents a band.
No, wait, you missed one here. This is the Sheraton Chicago Hotel and Towers presents the Olentangy Orange Marching Pioneers from Lewis Center, Ohio, Paul.
Yeah.
195 members. It's the first time in the parade. Let's listen.
Olentangy.
Did I spell it?
Olentangy.
Oh, did I?
That's all right.
Olentangy.
Now we both have one mistake. That's all right. It's even now. More of those little horses. Look out.
Oh, look at them moving.
Whoa,
yeah,
hey.
Come on.
Bringing it.
Yeah.
Ohio funk there.
That is awesome.
There we go. Look out. This is potential trouble now.
All right. The Double L Equestrian presents Santa's Elves and Reindeer. Riders and drivers of all ages and the horses are lined up in Santa's roll call order, ready for takeoff.
Uh-huh.
With Rudolph and his red nose in the lead. They're all lined up.
His nose, red nose is a little high, but that's all right. Close enough.
Stay tuned, boys and girls. Santa on the way.
Yeah. Uh-oh, there he is.
Oh, well, we've been telling you he's coming for 3 hours. He's finally here.
And he's presented by Case IH.
And I think Anna is going to be on the float with Santa in just a moment. I don't know if she's made her way up yet. But we don't want to catch her at an unflattering angle. So let's let her climb up on the float first.
Sure, that'd be fair.
And they have a little discussion with Santa.
And Mrs. Claus in the front.
Mrs. Claus there, too. Chicago's finest.
Toys for boys and girls again.
Hello.
Hear those sleigh bells jingle jangle.
You better be friendly.
Yeah.
Because, you know, you've got some tickets up here, don't you?
Yeah. Cover
your head, cause Santa Claus comes tonight.
Nice to see you.
Santa and Mrs. Claus looking good. And Anna Bellaval getting ready to join them on the floor.
All right, Anna, get on up there, Grace.
Yeah.
Here we go. Left, right.
Yeah.
Here she comes. There.
Very graceful. Oh,
yes.
Oh, boy.
Uh-oh, we got a sign in the way.
Hi, Santa Claus.
How are you?
Finally, you made it.
I made it. It's a long, wonderful drive.
I know. You're super busy. Yep. We really appreciate you being here with us today.
Oh, thank you. Thank you.
I'm sure you have a lot of stories to tell from all over the world.
You know, Anna, do you have a moment? I'll tell you a story about a fox.
Is that your favorite story?
That is one of my favorite stories.
Really?
It is. I mean, are you ready for it?
What's it about again?
It's about a fox.
No.
Yes, it is.
Dog goes woof, cat goes meow, bird goes tweet, and mouse goes squeak. Cow goes moo, frog goes croak, and the elephant goes toot. Ducks say quack, and fish go blub, and the seal goes ow, ow, ow. But there's one sound that no one knows. What does the fox say? Suddenly you're standing still. Your fur is red, so beautiful, like an angel in disguise. But if you meet a friendly horse, will you communicate by morse? Morse, morse. How will you speak to that?
Claus could bring it like
she
that.
She can knock it around.
Wow.
Congratulations, Santa. Good to see you. Well done.
Well, happy Thanksgiving, everyone. It's been a great day, and we hope you join us again next year.
Yeah.